established the moon and the sun. You fixed all the boundaries of the earth. You made both summer and winter.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalms 134 and 135.
For Israel and his people.
O Lord, your name
reading from the book of Numbers, the 23rd chapter, beginning in the 11th verse. Balak said to Balaam, "What have you done to me? I brought you to curse my enemies, but now you have done nothing but bless them." He answered, "Must I not take care to say what the Lord puts into my mouth?" So Balak said to him, "Come with me to another place from which you may see them. You shall see only part of them and shall not see them all. Then curse them for me there." So he took him to the field of Zophim, to the top of Pisgah. He built 7 altars and offered a bull and a ram on each altar. Balaam said to Balak, "Stand here beside your burnt offerings while I meet the Lord over there." The Lord met Balaam, put a word in his mouth and said, "Return to Balak, and this is what you shall say." When he came to him, he was standing beside his burnt offerings with the officials of Moab. Balak said to him, "What has the Lord said?" Then Balaam uttered his oracle, saying, "Rise, Balak, and hear, listen to me. O son of Zippor, God is not a human being that he should lie, or a mortal that he should change his mind. Has he promised, as he will not do it? Has he spoken, and he will not fulfill it? See, I received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot revoke it. He has not beheld misfortune in Jacob, nor has he seen trouble in Israel. The Lord their God is with them, acclaimed as a king among them. God who brings them out of Egypt is like the horns of a wild ox for them. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, no divination against Israel. Now it shall be said of Jacob and Israel, 'See what God has done. Look, a people rising up like a lioness and rousing itself like a lion. It does not lie down until it has eaten the prey and drunk the blood of the slain.'" Then Balak said to Balaam, "Do not curse them at all, and do not bless them at all." But Balaam answered Balak, "Did I not tell you? Whatever the Lord says, that is what I must do." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He has mercy on those who fear him.
third chapter, beginning in the 13th verse. Pilate called together the chief priests, the leaders, and the people, and said to him, "You brought me this man as one who has perverted the people. And here I have examined him in your presence, and have not found this man guilty of any of your charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us. Indeed, he has done nothing to deserve death. I will therefore have him flogged and release him." Then they all shouted out together, "Away with this fellow, release Barabbas for us." This was a man who had been put in prison for an insurrection that had taken place in the city, and for murder. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again, but they kept shouting, "Crucify him, crucify him." A third time he said to them, "Why? What evil has he done? I have found in him no ground for the sentence of death. I will therefore have him flogged and then release him." But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that he should be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate gave his verdict that their demand should be granted. He released the man they asked for, the one who had been put in prison for insurrection and murder, and he handed Jesus over as they wished. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you will not set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see. A light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us by your Holy Spirit. Almighty God, you have built your church upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Grant us so to be joined together in unity of spirit by their teaching, that we may be made a holy temple acceptable to you. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works. Give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed from the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, stay with us, for evening is at hand and the day is past. Be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts, and awaken hope, that we may know you as you are revealed in Scripture and the breaking of bread. Grant this for the sake of your life.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit.